Today's workout is a pull workout, pull muscle, back biceps. As I said in my push workout, I put legs into its own workout, so that's a 3-day split. I do split the core abdominal workout into transverse, oblique, and rectus abdominis. So transverse was with the push. Today will be oblique at the end of the pull. So we're going to start with our back, and we're going to do rows. If you have dumbbells, that's fine. If you have a barbell, if you have two bottles, if you have no equipment, I had oil jugs I was using yesterday. You can use water jugs. You can fill bags, sturdy bags, with weighted things. Make sure it's balanced, though. So we're just going to do a warm-up set. All right, so heels under hips. I'm going to face the side just so you see the hinge. Heels under hips, right? These soft shoulders up, back, down. We're going to hinge from the hips, and we're going to row. Bring the elbows back. Contract the trap muscles to each other. All right, just warming it up. So the elbows pull back. Make sure that you're breathing throughout. Engage your core. So especially in this position, we might tend to let the belly hang out. If we do that, though, we are not protecting the back. There is no support. So, all right, let's add the weight that we want to put on. So again, for those going really heavy, you can put it on. Back is a strong muscle. So it is one of, you know, legs the strongest. The back. I know a lot of people don't have a lot of equipment, so if that's the case, you do more reps. Our goal is to get no more than 10 to 12. Eventually, you want to get to a point where you do 4 to 6, and we'll do like 5 to 6 sets of that. But for now, since we all might be limited, all right, let's go for no more than 10 to 12. All right, I'm going to face front. Heels under hips, reset, knees soft, engage the core, and let's hinge, and we row. 1, 2, 3. All right, this is 8, 9, 10. I'm going to try to get 2 more. And we're going to rest it down. All right, take a little bit of a short break. So very little rest in between the sets. We're going to go for a total of 5 sets on this. If you can, if you do have extra weights and you need to add, just add a little more if you feel it was too light. But we will do 5, so you will probably fatigue. So let that be. The shorter rests will take care of that compensation for not adding weight. All right, second set. Again, get your form. Fingers should be close to the outside of the thigh. We hinge and we row. 1, 2. So think of the breathing as well. You want to exhale on the exertion phase. Inhale on the return phase. All right, that's 6, 7. We try not to rush the move as well, so that we use pure muscle force to get it to move. All right, try to get 1 more. Good, and rest it down. Good. All right, 3 more sets to go. So a lot of people, if you have machines as well, a lot of things you can do, seated rows with a pulley. If you have bands, you can use the bands too. It's actually a really good idea. You can do, just so you know, and this one is broken, but right, if you put your feet on the band, you've got your row. So that's always an option. Okay, third set. Remember, be careful picking it up, especially if it's heavy. All right, hinge and 1. 3. 8, 9, 10. Try to get two more if you can. If you are done, then you are done. And rest it.
Good.
I always tell my classes that sometimes I don't like to dictate a number. I let your body tell you. Your body will tell you when you're done, if you're honest with it. Right? Not when it just gets hard, but when you're like, I just cannot do another rep with the right form, you're done. All right, fourth set. One. Good, pull the elbows all the way back. So you're pulling the weight towards the belly button. If you're doing dumbbells, you might have better range because you can go a little further. You can go right to the hips, between belly button and hips. And I'm going to try to get two more. Gently put it down. All right, we're going to do one more set with that, okay? Feels good. All right. So especially being in that hinge, give it a nice... All right, last set. All right, reset, heels under hips, hinge, flat back, engage the core, and one, two. One of the challenges you can do is make sure that you hold that row for a good second or two. Seven for me, eight, nine. It definitely is harder to get that 10 to 12 here. And one more. Good, gently put it down. All right, first down. All right, we're gonna go to, if you were using dumbbells, we're gonna stay with that. You can switch to that if you were using a barbell. Either way, you can stay with the barbell too. Either option, it does not matter. We're going to go with an underhand grip for rows. But I'm going to go to dumbbells just to show it on something else. Okay. Move that. So same position, except this time, right? We're facing forward with the palms. Hinge, we pull. One. Two. So I'm bringing it right to my hips. This will add a little bit of the bicep to the work. It's actually called the bicep row. Rest. Good. We don't need a warm-up set with this because we just warmed up the back. And biceps are our sister on back. Easy way to remember, your sister muscles, back buys, BB, chest tries. So your tries assist usually on your chest moves. Okay. I think I'm going to go back to my bar. But stay with whatever you're doing, whatever works. Underhand grip, knee soft, hinge, and row. One, two, three, I am six down. All right, I am at 10. I'm going to try to get my 12. And so, I mean, if you're a beginner to this, you're just going to go with a lighter weight. You still want to get that basic move, that hinge. Make sure the back is flat, core is engaged, and the pull is here. Right? So you're coming basically more towards the hip, but between belly button, hip. more intense, more advanced, you go heavier. Okay. We're only going to do four sets on this. Four sets. And this is number two. Actually, number three. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. All right, I got 10. I'm going to try one more. Okay. All right. I hope you're feeling okay. Ooh, the short rest actually makes it a little bit harder. Pick it up safely. Reset. Hinge. And one. That's nine for me. 10. So when you are done, you are done. Some people always say, well, how do I know if I'm done? First sign is, if your form has changed and it's off, you're done. Don't bother, because if you're going to get bad form out of it, you're not going to get the muscle work you want. So you're done. Otherwise, you'll feel it and the muscle will say, I cannot do it anymore. All right, so that was four sets of that. By the way, shout out to professional physical therapy. I have one bicep, right, attached to my humerus, and this one is attached to my rotator, and they got me working back. So, Dr. Goodwillie, physical therapy, professional. Okay, so next we're going to go to pullovers. All right, I'm going to do it on the floor, because maybe a lot of you don't have a platform. All right, you want to pick a heavier weight. Important part of this is that when you're laying on the floor, right, well, keep your knees bent. Make sure that back imprints the floor. The move is right through the shoulder, right? This is the pullover. I don't want to hit the floor with it. Right, so I want to stop right above, and I'm going to bring it back to a little below belly button. If I bring it back and I find my back starts arching, right, if I go back and it arches, right, I want to make sure I keep it down. Right, so I want to tuck my pelvis under, get that connection to the floor or step if you're using it. I like a double V hold. So people who are new and you have a dumbbell, it's two V's, right? And you just hold it this way. That way you have support on both sides. Back gets pressed in. We're only doing three sets of this. So bring it down slowly. And then up. So being on the floor, you don't have that luxury of having a little space above you. So you just want to make sure, even if you touch the floor, that you're not dropping it. And that the resistance is heavy enough so that you have control and you literally feel like you are resisting that weight to go back and down, right? You want to control it and not let it control you. Your exhale is on the exertion phase. I know it both feels like exertion. All right, that's eight, nine, 9. All right, I'm going to go for two more, and one more. Good, short rest. Okay. I love pullovers so much. So really good for the rotator too, right? Opening it up. Not if you have a bad rotator. You don't want to do that. Go to your physical therapist for that. All right, second set. Very little rest. Okay. And again. All right, press that spine into the floor. And again, if you have a platform, a bench, step, whatever, that you lay on, it gives you that height so that when you go back, you have a little more space and you won't hit the floor. Right, I am on six. So this actually is a really good exercise for the back, the high back by the neck. A lot of times you see that V cut. I'm going to try to get one more. Good, and we're going to rest. All right, we have one more set. All right, you can also, if you want, you can do it holding it, depending on your bar, on your dumbbell. So if you have two ends like that, you can do it that way too. I personally like keeping the center of gravity in one spot. But this is a little bit harder to try to balance out the weight between both sides. So that is one way to make it harder. Right. Changing position of weights, where the point of gravity is, the point of balance. All right, let's try to get a few more. All right. All right, one more for me. Ah, good. So, I mean, if you looked really closely, you might have been able to see how I was trying to balance. I know I could feel that, but... Okay, so we're going to go to the biceps. All right, we're going to start with a hammer curl. You could do it seated, you could do it kneeling, you could do it standing. If you want to get more feel for your core, you would do it standing. All right, let me do this. All right, so palms are facing in, right? Soft knees, tuck the pelvis under. So even when you're using your biceps to do the exercise, your core is your stability. So you are using the core, so but you need to feel that, right? So you're sinking your feet into the mat or the floor. Knees are soft, pelvic tucked under. This is what stabilizes your back, your middle, the whole core from here to here, right? Palms facing in, we come up to the shoulder and we come down. And again, we're gonna control it and I'll tell you why. And what you'll see often is this, ready? That swing. So I'm letting momentum move my weight. I don't really want to do that. I want to just let the muscle focus in on that. Let the muscle do the work. Up, squeeze, and down. Something else I tell my classes is not to choke the dumbbells. So a lot of times, you squeeze it hard, kind of take away from the power in the bicep because you're focusing on squeezing here. So as long as you have control over the dumbbells and you're not going to drop them, that is tight enough. So the exertion is that up, that's where your exhale is, and the down. always have to have that squeeze. So you have to make that contraction, right? Having weight in your hand does not make it for you. It just adds intensity for you. So, all right, I'm going to do one more, and then I'm just going to show you something. So if you finished your set, take a little bit of a rest. If I didn't have dumbbells, I can do it, squeeze it, and I will still feel it, right? Because I'm creating the contraction. Okay, so again, the weights just add the intensity. All right, second set. Don't have you. If you fatigue, you can always do one side at a time, right? All right, second set. And again, you want to make sure your whole core is stable, right? No swinging of the back to get the weight up. If that's the only way you're getting the weight up, go lighter. Right? If you want to push the weight to challenge yourself, and I will show you, use the other hand to assist you on the concentric, the contraction part, and let it come down, get the negative on the eccentric part, because that's where the growth of the muscle occurs most of the time anyway. All right, up. So there are different ways, right? If you don't have anyone there to spot you, you can make it harder, right? By assisting yourself, right? Especially in these quarantine days, we don't have spotters all the time. I don't know if you live with someone who's your workout buddy, but if you don't, you are your own workout buddy. Good. And I'm done with mine. Okay. I think that was three sets. Was that three? You know what? Let's go for another one. If not, we're doing four. Okay. All right, let's go. One. Two, right? Don't forget that squeeze. Three. Four. Five. Ah, ha, ha. Getting tired. All right, six. Seven. Again, when your muscle tells you you're done, then you're done. Don't worry about it. If you feel like you have a couple more, but you're going to expend fast, do one at a time, right? I can rest one side while I work the other. Well, my body's saying I am done. So I'm finishing. All right. Stretch. Again, on this stretch, by the way, for the bicep, if you have any issues with your wrist, don't push your palm back. You could do it without it. You can get just as good a stretch. All right, so we're staying with a curl. We are staying with the bicep, but we're going to do a zonten curl, right? We're going to come up, and then we rotate, and we come down. So it works the biceps, forearm. You might have to go a little lighter. You have to see for yourself. Sometimes it's a testing game. You want to make sure your elbows are kind of locked in, though, right? Same thing on the regular curl. You want to lock them to the hip. But as you come up, and I'll go from the side, we come up, I rotate, I want to control it down, and I don't want the arm to come away. So I come up, and I control it down. Up. Down. So it's up, rotate, and down. Remember that grip on the bicep, right, on the weight. Sorry. So we don't want to squeeze too tight, right? There are certain exercises. We do want to increase our grip strength. This doesn't have to be one of them, right? We can do carries. And that's a really good one to work on, strength. You can always do it on chest presses too. Again, you want to control it both directions, right? Don't let it drop. All right, this is the end for me on that one. Okay, give it a stretch. I think for my second set, I'm going to go a little bit heavier just to challenge it. So, again, if I go heavier, I may not get as many as I was getting before. All right, short rest. Rest is over. Ab, bring it up. Rotate, bring it down. Rotate, bring it up. Bring it down. From the side. Up, rotate, down. Up, down. Whoo! Okay. Few more, if you can. If not, you are done. Oh, I think I have one left in me. We'll try. And I am done. Okay. All right, one more set. I'm gonna go back lighter. How are you feeling? I'd be feeling pumped, right? So the next time I put on a push or a pull, well, specifically for this one, pull, might have a couple of different exercises. So you have different options too. And again, with machines, there are always even more options, right? Different equipment, different options. Zamens, bring it up. Rotate, control it down. Two. This is three. All right, so what I was saying before about people with huge muscles who work out, who look amazing, right? So sometimes doing exercise like this, you might find this to get it up. And then some people just drop it and let it swing, right? If you have to do that, right? It's a chance, it's a way off. Do you want to hurt your back eventually to lift heavier weight than to do it safely and grow the muscle in a safer way? Those are the payoffs and the way outs and everything you have to consider. And, you know, young people have youth on their side that they don't necessarily feel it. And then years down the road, they might say, oh my God, why does my back always feel so sore? Oh, a disc is moved. Who knows? Everything can happen. Anything can happen. All right, I've got one more. All right. So, shake out the arms. We're going to go to the core. All right, we are doing transverse. I'm tucking this in so we can see a little bit. All right. So, obliques. I hope you can see. All right, so first on the obliques, we're going to put our knees together and take our feet out, right? Don't bring the heels very close to you because the goal is to try to reach to the heels. So we're going to push the spine into the floor, suck the belly button in, chest, shoulders up, right? Fist distance away for the neck, chin, and we're going to reach and reach. So don't just do this, right? We're not going to slide. We want to feel it squeeze through the oblique. Make sure you're breathing. Right? And while you're doing this, you have to still focus on the belly button into the spine, spine into the floor, right? So some people whose neck muscles are not yet worked, you might feel this is hard on the neck and you're feeling sore. Relax. Take a rest. And then you can come up and finish
or just make it a short set, and you could do a few more sets, that is. Or start slow. Okay, I'm going to get one more. And I'm going to relax. So instead of just doing three of these, I'm going to superset everything. Okay? Okay. We're going to do reach unders. Actually, no. Before we do that, let's see here. Let's do the bicycles while we're in this position. So, knees at 90. Hands by the ears or the temples, right? Don't grab and pull your neck, though. We want to just keep it here. Keep the elbows out. We're reaching with the shoulder. So a lot of times you're going to see this. I don't care if the elbow touches the knee. The reach is with the shoulder. So think of putting the elbow on the inside, reaching there. All right? And it's slow, slow. Make sure you're breathing. Same thing with the spine and the belly button. Two more in each. Good. Give it a fast stretch. All right. We're going to come over and do a reach under plank, side plank. All right. Your easier one. If you can do it on the wrist, that would be great. Hand, or if you're doing it on the forearm, either way, the forearm or the hand is right under the shoulder. Your first modification is bottom leg, the knee is down, hip stays off, and the top leg is here. We come up and we reach under, but we're not going to bend the whole core this way, right? You want to get a contraction here, so we go with a crunch and then back up. Right? Otherwise, you could be stacked or scissor. Same thing, we're here, we reach, contract, and bring it back up. Okay, let's go. Now you might feel this in the bottom part, which is what you're actually working. If you find that while you're doing this, you're fatiguing, come down and modify. You're still getting the same work. You can even do, modify one half, one more. Okay, other side. Yeah, so it does hurt the wrists a bit. So again, if you want to start, we could start this way. Whatever's comfortable for you. Okay, we reach under. Something to keep in mind is that your body's in a straight line. Right, no break in the hip. Two more. And relax. All right. We're going to circuit it again. And then that's going to be it. We'll just do a little bit of a stretch. Yeah, we'll only do two of these circuits. All right, knees together, heels out. So you can always choose to do more if you want. Okay, again, make it a goal to reach for the heel. Spine into floor, belly button into spine, chin fist distance away. Chest and shoulder up, and reach right to left. Again, don't let momentum work. Use the muscle focus. All We're going to do a couple extra. One more each. Good. And relax. Good. Get a nice stretch. Elongate the spine. Feels good. All right. Hands by the temple, the head, either way, elbows out. Knees at 90 degrees. Again, slow bicycle. Reach in. And other side. Again, you're thinking shoulder to the knee, not so much the elbow. If you do touch and you have a lot of rotation, that's fine. Remember, if you are feeling it in your neck, take a little rest. Come back when you can. One more extra, okay? And stretch it out. Okay, going to those reach under planks. So again, forearm, hand, knee, leg, whichever one is comfortable. And reach under, one. All right, so you should be feeling it through that side. Give me two more. Good, rest. We're going to go to the other side. Ooh. Oh, God. Okay. I'm going to go with my hand. And reach. All right, give me three more if you can. And we're done. Good. Yeah, kind of gets the wrist. Okay, so let's stretch out the back. All right. So bring your elbows to your thighs, round out the low back. So if you're not sure how to do that, think of what I told you about the floor is sucking the belly button in, right? Then breathe through it. Good. Okay. Let's come up, dive stretch. So arms right outside the ears. Should say ears inside the arms. Round out the upper back like you're doing a dive. Breathe through it. So good. Good. Take your hands to your thighs. Go roll up through the spine. One vertebrae at a time. Head's the last thing to come up. Sink back down. And again, roll through the spine. Keep it up. Shoulders up, back down. Roll it. Yeah, I know. I know we didn't do shoulders. Okay. Biceps. So again, you can just stretch it out this way. If you don't have any issues with the wrists, you can make it a little bit deeper. Right? You don't have to do that. So whatever's comfortable, you just kind of want to elongate where the bicep muscle is.
good. And the other side, same thing, right? If I don't want to push the hand back, I can just go as far as it's comfortable. Or I obviously, when I do this, am extending the stretch more so. But that's fine. Good. And I know we didn't do shoulders, but part of back, take the hands behind, shoulders up, back down. And I know people do this for chest and shoulders, but I feel like when we work the back, this kind of helps, right up in the trap area. Maybe because of the surgeries, but I do feel this in my bicep too. Well, I'll say my right. And relax it, shake it out. Okay, so again, if you need to stretch for your midsection, I just want to stretch it out, right? Elongate the spine. We can get a little bit of a thoracic stretch if you want. Just bring it down so you can see better, right? Just turn a little bit. So if you do that 1 foot, one knee, come to the outside of that knee, right? Thoracic rotation. So instead of just swinging from side to side, breathe through it. Good. Come center, switch sides. And again, this goes to the outside. And I rotate. Breathe through it. Good. Come center. And you can stay down, you can come up, take a nice breath. Take your hands, pat your back, you did a great job. I look forward to seeing you again. Next one, legs, right? Part of the three routine.